meeting. So first of all, just to wish you all a good morning and welcome you to Liverpool City Region Overview and Scrutiny Committee. I just need to make a few housekeeping announcements. Mobile phones, can they all be switched off and turned to silent, please? Can I remind members and presenters to use the microphones when presenting, please? There is not a fire alarm test today. If, however, the fire alarm does sound, can you please leave the building immediately by the sign exits? And this meeting will be filmed by the Combined Authority for live and or subsequent broadcast on the Combined Authority website. And I've got a further announcement to make. Councillor Paula Murphy has resigned from the Overview and Scrutiny Committee. I would like to place on record our thanks to Councillor Murphy for her hard work and commitment during this time. Councillor Murphy has played a role in Overview and Scrutiny since 2015, including acting as Vice Chair of the Audit and Governance Committee. I'd like to wish her the best and once again thank her for serving on the Overview and Scrutiny Committee. I'd also like to welcome Councillor Liz Dowd from Sefton, who's been appointed to the LCR Overview and Scrutiny Committee. And I'll also welcome her next time if she does turn up. Okay, on to the next item, apologies for absence. Are there any apologies for absence?
We've had apologies from Councillors Wainwright, Dowd, Jackson, Stapleton.
Are there any further apologies? Jill, can I ask you, are we correct?
Chairman, just checking the numbers now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The meeting requires 14 councillors to be correct, and we are at 12. We are in correct today, Chairman.
In that case, having taken a look at the agenda, could you summarise what we'd be able to do today, please?
Chairman, looking at your agenda, item 3, 4, 7, 8 and 9 are all items that require you to be quorate in order to be able to proceed. Those items are approving your previous minutes, appointing a vice chair, appointing a member to the Audit and Governance Committee, reviewing the Liverpool City Region left task and finish work that was completed by the group, and setting further task and finish items for consideration. They would all require a quorate position in the committee. Items 5, which is the main meat of your agenda today, and item 6, the budget setting and the air quality. Whilst the members could have some opinion or some views on those to show with the Combined Authority, again, because you're on our quorum, it means that they carry less weight in the circumstances. So I think the balance of your agenda, Chair, is that you are able to proceed with most items of business.
So in that case, would you accept a proposal that this meeting doesn't go ahead as a formal meeting, and instead we have a private meeting among members just to discuss those two items, the budget setting and the air quality? Does that seem like a reasonable proposal?
Members can choose to behave in that way or not to proceed at all, but we are unable to progress business today in the way that we would wish and want to. That means that the webcast will stop and we'll ask members of the public to leave the room so that you can have a briefing if that's the way that members wish to proceed on the budget and the air quality issues, so that those that who have come can keep up to speed and be appraised of those key issues.
And further to that, because obviously we're going to miss out on completing a lot of the business of the Overview and Scrutiny Committee, I also request that we have an extra meeting arranged within the next few weeks, if that be possible.
Chairman, we'll work with you to agree a date and we will contact all members, but I imagine that would be in the next 3 weeks, because our next meeting is not planned until the 4th of March. I think it would be helpful to get those items of business transacted before the 4th of March. So we'll contact you to arrange a new date, and we'll be sending hopefully some correspondence to
so I'd like to thank all the members of the committee for attending who have done. I'd also like to thank members of staff for coming along, and also members of the public, I'd like to thank you for your interest and apologise that the meeting is in court yet again on this occasion. Can I? And at that point, I therefore conclude the formal.